ॐ अज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नमः ॐ विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिन् इति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात देशतारिणे वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धोभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। ओकं करोति वाचालं पंघं लंगयते गिरं यत्कृपा तमहं वंदे श्रीगुरुतारिणं श्रीचैतन्यमीश्वरं परमानन्दमाधवम्। हरे कृष्ण। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट बलराम जी। दाऊ जी भैया बलराम जी की जय। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बी डिस्कसिंग पास्ट टाइम्स ऑफ लॉर्ड कृष्णा विथ हिज काउहर्ड बॉयफ्रेंड्स। So that way we'll be celebrating how every day in Vrindavan is Friendships Day. We are going to be seeing that. So tomorrow, is Balaram Jayanti. So today we are going to be preparing our consciousness for Balaram Jayanti by discussing very, very sweet pastimes of Balaram Ji. All right. So here it goes. The first pastime. I'm going to be discussing two pastimes and then the lessons and also the history behind the pastime. So yesterday we had joined for the Krishna Leela, where we had seen, witnessed and experienced Krishna killing three demons. And today we are going to be witnessing killing of some more demons. Now in each demon in Vrindavan represents a particular anartha in the hearts of a Vaishnava. That is why we are relishing the killing of demons. Of course, we all like action scenes, right? Movies, what we usually wait for in movies? That action scene, fighting scene. That's what we relish. Similarly, even in Vrindavan, these action scenes, there are powerful, power-packed action scenes, but along with that, there are also lessons. Because more important than the story is the moral of the story. So story and the moral of the story is important. Both are important. So we'll be learning a lot of morals along with the story as well. Okay, here we go. So yesterday Krishna was in his Kumaravastha, just 3 to 4 years of age. But now we are going to go to a particular pastime where Krishna has reached his Paugandavastha. He has just become a Pauganda, which means Krishna from Vatsapal has been promoted to becoming Gopal. Tatascha Pauganda Vaya Shrito Vraje Bhavau Vatusto Pashupala Sammato Gascharayanto Sakibhim Samampader Vrindavanam Punyam Ativa Chakratu. It's an amazing, one of my favorite shlokas, where Krishna is actually going to take up the task of tending to cows. And we are all very happy. Hari Bol, Krishna, here you go. But the Vrajavasis were very sad. Because when it was calves, Krishna used to tend to calves near the house. But now Krishna is going to start going deep into the forests of Vrindavan. Because the cows require much more care, attention. So you have to go deeper. That's number one. And number two, what used to happen is the cows, tending of the cows used to take more time. Much more time than taking care of calves. So now Krishna is going to be away from home. Krishna is going to be away from Vrajavasis for much longer time. So this was not a very happy news for them. Actually, Krishna had turned into a legal, you know, we call it teenager like that, a legal Pauganda on Janmashtami. But it took them almost 3 months on Gopashtami. That is when they sanctioned that Krishna, you go and... So it took 3 months. There was a committee meeting who were seriously considering, come on, now Krishna is old enough. He is 5 years and 3 months old. We should empower him with cows. Come on. And then finally, the request had to be considered seriously. And Krishna, on the day of Gopashtami, this comes on the Shukla Paksha, of the Kartik mass, yeah, the eighth day, lunar day, which is called Gopashtami. On this day, Krishna and Balaram and all of the cowherd boys became Gopal. Everybody got promoted. So everybody became Gopal, but Krishna is actually called as Gopal. So it is the pastime which is taking place at that time. It is said that Vrindavanam Punya Tirtham Avatirtha Satkartu. So this particular shloka of Bhagavatam says that Krishna and Balaram made the land of Vrindavan much more Punya. How is that? Because Krishna and Balaram started putting their footprints on Vrindavan. Krishna Balaram was before also putting footprints. Correct. They were marking their footprints before also, but now they become bigger. Yes, 5+ years of age. They have grown up in age. And so the impressions were much more lasting. So, Sanchintayet Bhagavatas Charanaravindam Vajra Ankusha Dvaja Saroruha Lanchanadim. So, all these different marks of Dvaja, the flag, the thunderbolt, the lotus, the fish, and different symbols which are there on Krishna's lotus feet, they were all getting imprinted on Vrindavan, which was increasing the beauty of Vrindavan. Dear devotees, it is said that there is not a single speck of dust in Vrindavan which was not touched by Krishna's lotus feet. Everywhere Krishna had put his lotus feet, and Vrindavan is full of Krishna's lotus feet. That's why Vrindavan was very beautiful. That added to the beauty of Vrindavan. Yes. And another thing is Krishna is referred to here as Madhava. Now Madhava also means a spring season. What happens in spring? What happens in spring? All the flowers, they blossom. That's a season where all the leaves, flowers, buds, fruits, everything blossoms, and the Prakriti Sundari, the material nature, manifests its complete total beauty. Correct? So Krishna is called Madhav. That's another meaning of spring. It is Krishna who caused all the fruits, flowers, everything to blow up. So that was Krishna's manifestation. Because ultimately Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, Maya Dhyakshena Prakriti Suyatesa Characharam. Yeah. And when Krishna used to move about, he used to see all these trees and keep smiling at them. And when the trees, he would smile at the trees would give out some flowers and offer it to Krishna's lotus feet, give out some fruits and offer it to Krishna. So it was a very personal reciprocation. And some of the trees, they would actually bow down with their weight and touch Krishna and Balaram's lotus feet, saying that, see, Krishna, Balaram, you are walking with your other cowherd boyfriend, Samshu, Stoka Krishna, and Subal, Sridhama. You are all going with them, but we are unable to walk behind you. We are so unfortunate. So because we have got this lowly birth, usually the lowest species, the lowest rank among the 8.4 million species, Janajala Valakshani, Stavara Lakshamimshati, the 20 lakh species of immovables, and tree is considered to be the lowest birth. So we got that lowest birth. But see, in Vrindavan, despite getting a lowest birth, the lowest birth, they were so fortunate that they were able to offer fruits and flowers to Krishna directly. So even a tree in Vrindavan is very fortunate, and trees in Vrindavan is also called as Kalpavriksha, which means they are all spiritual desire tree. They can fulfill any desires. And even today, the trees are desire trees, spiritual desire trees. So like this, Krishna and Balaram and the Pauganda Leela on the Gopashtami day, they had started their particular pastime, and all the Gopa friends were all very, very happy. And now suddenly, Vedic culture, we have to understand a little bit. Suddenly, Amshu, Stoka Krishna, Shridham, they looked at each other and they said, we have a plan, Krishna. Balaram, we have a plan. Krishna, Balaram, we have a great plan. Can you please fulfill that? And Krishna, Balaram asked them, yes, please tell what to do. Especially they told Balaram, Balaram, we challenge you that today we want to go to taste some tal fruits. Tal is palm. It's called in English palm. So this, the palm trees fruits, they are called as tal fruits. Yes, bluish color, wonderful tal fruits. They are also called tal ali. So they challenged Krishna Balaram with great love that, can we go there? We want to taste this tal fruits. Actually, did they want to taste the tal fruits? No. They wanted Krishna and Balaram to taste the tal fruits. But if they say Krishna Balram, go and let us taste the tal fruits, then that is not so much of a feeling, an impetus. Krishna Balram will say, we don't want. So they are forcing. See, we want to take tal fruits, which means Krishna Balram, we want you to enjoy. Like in Vedic serving, suppose I am taking prasadam and there is a gulab jamun serving going on. And I want gulab jamun. You know what I should do? I should not say, Hare Krishna Prabhu, gulab jamun dijiye. No. What is the right way of serving? Hare Krishna Prabhu, please give this person gulab jamun. Side wale ko. Please give this person gulab jamun. And so when the server goes to give gulab jamun to him, he will say, no, I don't want. Then who called me? You called. Give him gulab jamun. Which means it should fall on whose plate? My plate. This is Vedic culture. No? Feelings ko samjho. We say, no? Hare Krishna Prabhu, bulaya matlab usko hi chahiye. That's what. He is called means that he is the person who is needing it. Please serve some puris, two puris to this person. That means that person wants two puris. You should first go to that person and give. Then side maybe you can give. So this is Vedic culture, understanding heart, yes, of each other. So they understood heart of Krishna Balram and they told, let us go. And this particular Talavan is exactly one yojana, 8 miles to the west of Mathura, very close to Kamsa. 8 miles. Usually in Vedic calculation, we have yojana calculation. One yojana is 8 miles. So that was 8 miles towards west of Mathura, the capital of Kamsa. There was Talavan. But nobody would dare to go to Talavan. We say tal fruits were not tasty. No, they were very tasty. Oh, they were very less in number. No, there was abundance. So much abundance that tal fruits used to be lying on the ground. Then why they never went there? Because there was a very, very strong security guard of Kamsa who used to be there. Who is that? His name was Dhenukasur. And this Dhenukasur was actually having the body of a donkey. So Dhenukasur was a donkey, and this donkey demon, he used to guard this particular garden of Talavan. So the cowherd boys understood that Dhenukasur was a very dangerous person. So they told, this Dhenukasur is there. So this Dhenukasur is the person who is guarding this Talavan. And Dhenukasur is famous for one more thing. You know what is that? He is very, very famous for eating human beings and animals alive. He used to just swallow. How you drink a soup or how you drink a juice, he used to swallow them, not eat. Swallow people inside. Men and animals, done. That's why nobody went near there. So although tal fruit was very, very sweet, because he swallowed it, nobody dared to go there. Even birds were afraid to fly because he had very nice range, long distance also. Bird under. That powerful was Dhenukasur. So even birds were afraid. They used to understand tal fruit ahead. Their GPS tracker. Birds and animals have a natural GPS. No problem. They don't need, what is that, Google Maps. They don't need that. So they used to avoid that place very tactfully and go. Yes. So cowherd boyfriends knew one technique. They knew technique. If you really want to encourage a person to fight, you should tell the strength of the enemy. You should keep glorifying the enemy. And the more we glorify the enemy, the more, really? Okay, fine. I'm getting ready. I'm getting all charged up to beat up that person. So they knew. They wanted to incite Krishna and Balram a little bit. So they kept glorifying Dhenukasur even more. That comes as trustworthy servant. He's filled with all his... He also has bodyguards, security guards in form of other donkeys. Yeah? Like that. But then they later on saw that Krishna and Balram were getting spirited looking at each other. Then they said, but don't worry. All these donkeys, when you go in the front, they will become like flowers in the sky. What is, which all flowers grow in the sky? Come on, no flowers grow in the sky. Which means, you go there, they will cease to exist. Samajh mein aaya? This is a poetic way. See, Vrajvasis are so poetic. See, one of the 26 qualities of Vaishnava is Kavi. Vaishnava is very poetic. So that is the poetic nature of the Vrajavasis. They are telling, you go in front of them, they will become like Akasha Pushpayate. Akasha Pushpa doesn't exist. There is nothing called tree which grow, tree or flower that grows in the sky. So it will become like that. So Krishna and Balaram finally decided, yes, my dear friends, Balaram is the leader today. So today, in this past time also, Balaram only was leading. Krishna was taking a back seat. Sometimes Krishna says, Dao Bhaiya, you lead today. So today, Balaram was the leader. He said, fine, we will go definitely to Talvriksh. We will find out. And then, how did they find out where is Talvan? Did they have GPS? How to find out? They had map of Vrindavan. They did not have any of these things. Then how is it that they found out where is Talfruit? Where is that Talvan? They knew the distance. How did they find out? Simple, by smelling. That is the power of Vrajvasi boys. That is one thing, and that's also the power of the fragrance of the Tal fruits. They were very, very fragrant. So these Vrajvasi boys, it's towards the east side. Yeah, come on. And even the Pavan Devata is the god of wind, was also helping the Vrajvasis. So Pavan Dev was engaging himself in Krishna's service and helping the cowherd boyfriends by sending fragrance this side. Come here, east side. And then, thus, towards the east, they started moving that time. And as soon as they came to Talvriksh, they saw the Talvan and they said, who gave the idea? Balaram was very happy. Very good idea. It's a great idea that we all came here. And all the cowherd boyfriends were very, very delighted. And then one cowherd boy said, shh, but what if Dhenuka comes here? That time both Krishna and Balaram looked at each other and they started laughing. Loudly they started laughing. They were thinking, how can a donkey be so powerful? You take one stick and go near them, they'll run away. They are so afraid. So why Krishna and Balaram laughed? Because they were thinking, Dhenuka is so powerful. How is that possible? That fellow, after all, is a donkey. How is he so powerful? Hoi nahi sakta. I think you are all telling lies. That's why they laughed. All friends are telling lies. Then Balaram went ahead. He went towards one of the tall fruits, tall trees. Although there were many tall fruits lying down, but wo niche gira hai. Usme maza nahi hai. Where is the fun? The fun is in going and catching the fruits. And how is the catching the fruits possible? Balaramji will show. So he pulled his sleeves, he went near, and with the strength of a mad elephant, he caught hold of the tree and shook. He shook the tree, and all the fruit started coming, and all the gopas started collecting one fruit. Hari bol. So one by one they started catching the fruits, and they were all very happy. So some fruits were caught very smoothly, but many of the fruits fell down. They fell down. On hearing the sound of the fruits falling down, somebody got really angry and irritated. Who is that? Dhenukasur. He got very wild, angry, and as Balaramji was being cheered up, yay, by all his friends, suddenly Balaramji experienced something striking his chest with the full force. Somebody had struck him, and Balaramji went a little distance back and fell down. Who was that? Dhenukasur had arrived. So he had come, he had showed his back towards Balaramji and gave him a strong kick with his two hind legs. That was the force of Dhenukasur. He pulled him behind. So everybody was shocked. Oh, what happened? Balaram, are you okay? Are you all right? And Balaramji said, bring it on. So Dhenukasur was actually a gada, actually a donkey. You know why? Because he used to go great distance. He used to come. We come with full force. He used to run and come and stop. He used to apply brake. Apply the brake, do about turn, and then kick. Then why to run all this distance? Is it making any good sense to run all this distance, stop, turn around, and then give a kick? No meaning, right? That's why he was actually a donkey. We got the correct body. Gadha. Donkey. He was coming with full force, stopping and turning. And trying to kick. And Balaramji used to dodge the kick so easily, so predictably. He used to stand like this. Ajao, come. So he used to come all the way. He used to stand. And when he used to turn around, Balaramji used to move aside. And he used to kick in the air. And he missed the kick. Now Balaramji said, enough. Bahut ho gaya. It's good enough. We had enough fun. Now let's teach this fellow a lesson. Can we finish him? Yes. So Balaramji took out his next time the donkey came turned around he extended his left hand and with his one left hand he caught hold of both the legs of Dhenukasura and then we all know what happened the standard signature move of both Krishna and Balram this is the original martial arts judo karate everything is a derivative of Krishna and Balram arts he caught like this zoop he started rotating in the rotation only this fellow died finished hawai mein mar gaya in the air only he died and after that Balramji was looking where to put him where to put him where to put him and he saw a very beautiful tall standing palm tree so he threw him there and Dhenukasur went hit the palm tree many of the fruits fell down and cowherd boys went and collected those fruits and that tree fell on another tree and many more fruits came down that tree fell on another tree and many many fruits came down and all fruits came down and cowherd boys were very very happy and they were getting so much of fruits yes because that kept shaking many many more trees and the entire forest was completely shaken and the whole of the ambience the cowherd boyfriends they were all very very happy yay very nice but some people were not happy who is that Krishna and Balram's friends were happy but Dhenukasura's friends were happy they were not happy they became very angry and they all came in gang big gang to attack Krishna and Balram and each time the friends would come Krishna and Balram used to take zoop 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 next come zoop 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 next zoop 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 next like that the entire tal one was full of tal fruits and on top of the palm tree were lying the dead donkeys with blood smeared out so it was the donkeys were bluish in color it is described and the blood flowing out was reddish so it was like the sunset view so in a sunset view eating this wonderful tal fruits isn't that an amazing experience so they were all watching the sunset they were watching the fight scene and they were eating fruits what a joy Krishna and Balram gave to all the cowherd boy friends and they were all really really very happy yes so Dhenuka had been killed so now that place was open for all public to come all animals all birds all public they all could come because Dhenukasura is no more there and that's all because of Krishna and Balaram Hari Bol so now you noticed one thing Krishna did not kill this demon Balaram killed this demon there's a reason why and for that you have to know the history behind Dhenukasura which I'll tell you in Garga Samhita there is a description that comes that Dhenukasura in his past life was his name was Sahasika means one who is courageous and Sahasika was the son of Bali Maharaj so this Sahasika was a very powerful king and he was also very beautiful so he was enjoying with many many women in a particular mountain which comes in the Ilavart Varsha called Gandhamadhan mountain you remember Gandhamadhan mountain Gandhamadhan mountain is the same mountain which Hanuman ji carried for rescuing Lakshman so on that mountain he was enjoying and they were all creating noise and disturbance and there Durvasa Muni was sitting and doing his tapasya om and he got disturbed who is disturbing me so he went there and he saw Sahasika with 10,000 women disturbing him and he became so upset he said rascal how dare you are disturbing my meditation by behaving like a fool you behaved like an ass you donkey so you become an ass in the next life and this naturally what he will do what he would have done he would have gone and begged at the feet of Durvasa Muni please forgive me please I'm sorry please do something he said okay fine you will not be born as an ass right now Durvasa Muni did his calculation you will be born as an ass after 4 lakh years yes why 4 lakh years yes because that time Krishna and Balaram are going to appear in Mathura and that is where you will also appear in Mathura Mandal and you will be in the sacred forest of Talwan is a very sacred forest so you will be in Talwan And there you will be liberated by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Balaram. Why not Krishna? Because Krishna in the form of Narasimha Deva had promised Prahlad Maharaj that I will not kill your 21 generations. I'll rather liberate your 21 generations. And Bali Maharaj is the grandson of Prahlad. Because of that, Krishna did not touch Dhenukasur. Said, "Ye merani, Balaram ji, you go. Kill. I've given promise. I'll keep my promise." So Sahasika in the form of Dhenukasur was not killed by Balaram. There's another reason also. This is the pastime. The reason of pastime. There's also a reason of tattva or lesson, philosophy. Dhenukasur represents ignorance. Yasyatma buddhi kunapeti dhatuke swadikalatradishu bhaumya ijjati yattirtha buddhi salilena karhichi janeshu abhigneshu saeva ghokarah. So this ignorance refers to not knowing one's position or thinking oneself to be the body. We are not this body, we are soul. That is the philosophy of Bhagavad Gita. But to consider oneself to be the body and not the soul and not act as servants of Krishna, that is something which is called as ignorance. And ignorance is destroyed by Guru. And Balaram is Adi Guru. So Balaram or Guru destroys ignorance, not Krishna. So that is why this pastime is very special. Balaramji, that's why we say now, Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya. Ajnana means ignorance. Who destroys? Chakshurunmilitamyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. We pray to Guru for dispelling the ignorance. So this is the pastime of Dhenukasur. So Dhenukasur is delivered and we are exactly reached our half time. So I have one more pastime. So this pastime is also very special. I remember something from this pastime. This particular pastime, I was just 3 years back, I was in Chennai, in ISKCON Chennai. And we are having, fortunately with us, our Janakiram Prabhu and Murutul Prabhu. They are also here from ISKCON Chennai. So I had met these wonderful friends in Chennai when I was there. So I had joined for the morning program in Chennai. We had a very nice Guru Puja. And after the Guru Puja, the temple president, His Grace Sumitra Krishna Prabhu, comes and tells me, "Prabhu, you are giving today's class." And I asked, "When is the class?" I thought usually in Pune the system was, after Guru Puja, there used to be prasadam and then class. So prasadam time, I'll sit and prepare for class. He said, "Class is immediately after." That was my first day in ISKCON Chennai temple. He said, "Class is immediately after Guru Puja." I was like, "What? I don't even know which verse I'm going to take." He said, no, "Prabhu, you are from Pune." So Pune ka, everywhere, somebody thinks you're from Pune. Well, Pune, you're from Pune, you can do anything. You're all trained by Radhesham Prabhu. You know everything. I said, "Kya?" Everything. Chalo, I opened and saw what was there. So it was this chapter. And somehow Vishwanath Chakravarti Padu, is a very famous acharya, has written commentary. I've read personally the 10th canto many times of Chakravarti Pada. I had even made notes. So by Krishna's mercy, I knew this particular chapter. And that is a chapter which I'm going to discuss. Because now it is a summer in Vrindavan. And that time it was also summer in Chennai. So it was summer in Chennai when I had come, and it is summer in Vrindavan. So I had gone to Chennai after a long time, and I was telling them that this was summer in Vrindavan, but summer in Vrindavan appeared like spring. And the devotees there told me, "Prabhuji, spring in Chennai appears like summer. Ulta, that is Chennai. Chennai has only three climates, hot, hotter, hottest." I said, "Yeah, I also have experience. I have stayed 15 years in Chennai. Yeah, 12 years in Chennai. So I know very well the climate which is there." So this is summer in Vrindavan. And usually summer in Vrindavan, we've been in Delhi also. Delhi, Vrindavan, similar climate. The temperature sometimes even goes up till 55 degrees. But here in Vrindavan, in the presence of Sri Krishna and all his wonderful entourage, the summer was one of the best seasons, better than spring. In summer, we could hear the sound of waterfalls, amazing waterfalls. And we also can hear the sound of crickets. Cricket is another creature. I'll tell you something which happened. with my spiritual master. So my spiritual master had arrived on Mumbai airport in 2011. And that particular day was somehow the Indian cricket team, they had made it to finals against Sri Lanka. So Indian cricket team was playing the finals of Sri Lanka that day. So there was a news TV reporters all had come and they surrounded my spiritual master. So that time His Grace Gaur Gopal Prabhu was with my spiritual master. He told the reporter, hey, chalo chalo, niklo. Nahi, nahi, hum log aapke Swami ji. First of all, they liked, he's a Swami and that too, American Swami. Kya baat hai? America se Swami aaye hain. Zarur, we want to take interview. They said, nahi, nahi, chota sa interview. We just want to take, we want to ask who is going to win, India or Sri Lanka. That's all we want to ask. Nothing else. He said, why Swami ji does not know any cricket? The only cricket he knows is that particular insect which makes sound. That is the only cricket he knows. He doesn't know any cricket. He has never watched cricket in his life. And these people were determined. So as soon as Maharaj sat in the car, they surrounded the car and they knocked the windshield. And Maharaj looked and he lowered the screen. Fine, yes, how may I serve you? And these people said, Swamiji, can you please tell us who is going to win today's match, India or Sri Lanka? Is there a match today? Then he asked Gaur Gopal, do we have any program today? No, nobody will come if there is a match. The two final World Cup. He said, well, 40 years back, I had come to India and the Indians treated me very nicely. They took care of me, so India will win. And they're happy. That's all we want. Boss, no problem. Maharaj, no clue of cricket. So in India, you say cricket, that is the cricket they know. And in America, you talk about cricket, that is the cricket, the insect. That is the only cricket that they know. So in Vrindavan, the sound of cricket, not how is that, clean bowled, not that sound. The sound of those crickets used to be there. Yeah. And along with that, beautiful sound of waterfalls. This was the summer. Yes. Beautiful winds used to blow, the waves of the winds. They used to take wonderful pollen grains, transport them across. And because of this, water lilies, lotuses, and wonderful water bodies, Vrindavan was very cool in summer. They're very, very comfortable. Yeah. And even in Govardhan, there were special caves in Govardhan. So during winter, the caves would be warm. And during summer, the caves would be very, very cool. Yes, so because of the gentle breeze, etc., this was the ambience. Nobody felt any heat at all. Yes, that was the ambience of Vrindavan. And many, many animals, beautiful animals and birds, peacocks, bees, cuckoos, cranes, all of them would be singing very beautifully. Yeah. And in this ambience, Krishna Balram, they had taken all their cows for tending and Krishna was playing his flute. The only reason Krishna used to go for herding cows was very simple. He wanted to play with his friends. That's all. The only reason was he wanted to have wonderful play along with his friends. That was the reason that he actually went to be with the friends. And what these cowherd boys would pay? These cowherd boys would dance. That's why Vrindavan Vasis means we should really dance in kirtans. They used to sing. They used to wrestle in a healthy way. Okay, healthy wrestling. Not the one that they show in the TV, WWF. Not that. So not that kind of wrestling. That is all usually fixed. Match fixing. Yeah. So they wrestled in a very dignified way. Vedic wrestling is very dignified one. Gentleman's game. So they played flutes. They played kartals. They even have bugles, buffalo horns. And they danced. And even when Krishna danced especially, all the cowherd boys would sing. And some of the boys would encourage. This encouragement was something very, very important. Yeah, in the Vedic time. Even when two Kshatriyas, they used to be fighting in the Vedic times, there would be music. They would give music, bugles, sound and increase that ambience. And there will be Suta Magadha Vandinaha, the bards, they will all glorify and they will encourage. Just like today commentators, they do, na? Yes. So, commentary, they give running commentary. Like that in Vedic times also, running commentary would be given to dancing of, especially dancing of Krishna. And Krishna would dance in a very dramatic fashion. Yes, like that. So, So this was the particular pastime. This was happening so wonderfully. And especially at that point of time, the cowherd boys, they were all playing wrestling. So sometimes they would wrestle and play Mallayuth. You know what is Mallayuth? on the ground. It wouldn't hurt because it was beautiful mud and sand. So even putting down, beating, pounding, nothing would hurt. And sometimes they used to play Niyuddhena. Niyuddhena is arm wrestling. Just as panja, we call, no? So that arm wrestling they used to play. These were the wonderful games which Krishna and the cowherd boys would play. So when like this Krishna and cowherd boys were playing, that time one demon came. Silently he came. Now this demon was strategic demon. He took the form of a gopa boy, a cowherd boy, and came inside to play. And that too, he had taken the form of a boy who had not come that day. He was absent. One boy was absent. He had to stay at home. Maybe his birthday. Usually on birthdays, their mother, father will not let them out to go and play. So that was the day. So he took the form exactly that of that cowherd boy. And he came. Yes. And his desire was very simple. His desire was to kidnap. Kidnap whom? He wanted to kidnap whom? He wanted to kidnap Balram. Because he saw the track history. He went to Wikipedia and he saw that Krishna has a track record. What an amazing track record. He has killed Putana, Shakatasur, Trinavrat. All these people he has killed. He has killed so many people. He must be definitely very powerful. Balram only Denukasur. So he thought that Krishna is a very deadly, dangerous fellow. I cannot defeat him. But I'll try to defeat Balram. He thought like that. Because Krishna's track record was very bad. So he thought, I will go and try to kidnap Balram. It will be easy. At least I'll kill him. And when Balram becomes very sad and more aware, Krishna becomes sad upon Balram being kidnapped and killed, then that I will take advantage of that time and then I will try to kidnap Krishna also. Okay? And this particular demon, his name was Pralambasur. Pralambasur. As soon as Pralambasur came inside, Krishna understood this fellow is a demon. Krishna understood. Arey, he's taken the form of a cowherd boy, but ye to achcha nahi. And Krishna used to try to go near him. I will kill him like this. I'll kill him like that. At the same time, I should not show my opulence. No Aishwarya in Vrindavan. In Vrindavan, only sweetness, Madhurya. Okay, I'll wait for the right time. This fellow makes this move, I'll immediately make the move. Okay? So then Krishna decided, okay, we'll do one thing. So, my dear friends, we are going to divide the tomb into a team. We are going to divide all the cowherd boys into two teams, equal teams. And I'll be one group leader and Balram will be the second group leader. So both of us together, we are going to be having a fight. And the condition of the game was, whoever wins will get to carry, the losers have to carry the winners on their back. Accepted? They all accepted. So chalo, let us make the team. So the teams were being divided. And this particular pastime happened in the Bhandirvan. Yes, this is a particular one of the 12 forests. So in Bhandirvan, this pastime was happening. Yeah. So there were many, many of them who was like Shridama, Vrishab. They were all very good friends of Balram. So they chose Balram's side. And Pralambasur understood. If I have to carry, suppose I want to carry Balram, then I have to be in separate team, right? If I be in the same team, I don't get to carry him. So he went and joined Krishna's team. He thought that, chalo, anyway, no problem. I will join Krishna's team. So I'll get to carry Balram. Yes. So he, and I, whenever I get out of sight, that time I will kill this Balram also. So like that. So Balram's team won. Usually Krishna would lose. And Krishna had to carry one of his friends. His name was Dama. Dama. Not Sudama. Sudama is also a name. But Dama. That was a friend Krishna had to carry. And all Krishna's team, entire team lost very badly this game. Yes. And so they all had to carry and they had to take the boy and go. And Pralambasur, he chose to carry Balram. And Pralamba was carrying Balram and he was going off the track. He was going to some other place. Where is he exactly going? He's going. And suddenly, as he kept going, Balram tried to tell him, hey, where are you going exactly? And he was not. He was running in full speed. And that is when Balram understood that actually I am being carried by a demon. So Balram started becoming as heavy as Mount Sumeru. He became, and then Pralamba started slowing down. He slowed down. And Balramji exhibited his opulence of having golden ornaments and he was looking like a full moon. Yes. And since Balramji had become very, very heavy, this Pralamba slowed down, but he still did not stop moving. He started moving swiftly. And then finally he decided, now I have to show my true form. So Pralamba assumed the form of a gigantic demon. Yes, his eyes were fiery. His hair were fiery. His teeth were terrible. And his brows were scowling. And seeing this sudden change, it appeared Balram became little frightened. Huh? What is this? Then he understood that this demon wants to kidnap me and take me away from Krishna. I tried to stop him. He is not stopping. So what do I do? This is another signature move of Balram. He took his fist. Push! He just smashed into the head of Pralambasur. And Pralambasur's head cracked immediately open. He vomited blood from his mouth. He fell down unconscious and became lifeless, just like Indra would smash a mountain by his thunderbolt. Balramji smashed the head of this demon and delivered him completely. And suddenly, hearing the sound, what happened? All the cowherd boys came there. The cowherd boys came and they saw, oh, Balram, you have killed this such a big demon. So they all started glorifying him, and they all went together and embraced Balram as though they had not seen him for a long time. Some say that they all went and embraced Balram as though he had come back from dead. Like that, they embraced him. They were all very, very happy. And even the demigods from the sky, they were also extremely happy, and they were showering flowers upon Balram, and thus this Pralamba demon was put to an end. Now, who is Pralamba demon in his last life? Remember Suhotra? Suhotra had stolen some of the flowers from the Chitra Sarovar, which were meant for Parvati to be offered to Krishna. Although Suhotra and his two brothers, who were also disciples of Duvasa Muni, they wanted to take some flowers and offer to Krishna as devotional service, because they were also Gandharvas, devotees. But since they stole flowers, they were all punished. Garga Samhita says they were punished by Kuvera, actually, not by Shiva. Kuvera is the head of that place. So since he disturbed the sadhana of Shiva and Parvati, he punished them for stealing and trespassing on others' property. So he punished them, and one of the brothers became Bakasur, whom you saw yesterday, and Pralambasur also was there, and another brother became Keshi. So that's what we saw. So he was Pralambasur, yeah, the brother of Suhotra. So what does Pralambasur represent? Pralambasur represents subtle lust. Subtle lust is puja, labha and pratishta. I'll explain. Lust actually is a covering on the soul, which covers the knowledge of the living entity. Misidentification, because of which one thinks one is an angel. Gross lust means an adamant desire to enjoy that which is prohibited. That is called gross lust. Adamant desire. I want, like Ravana, Mujhe Sita chahiye. I want Sita. But she is another man's wife. That is prohibited for you. But still he wanted to enjoy her. So then adamant desire to enjoy that is which is prohibited is actually Ravana tendency or lust. That is gross lust. And what is subtle lust? Subtle lust is profit, adoration and distinction. Puja, labha and pratishtha. That is called subtle lust. Now this is something which is not so detectable. Yeah. Now what is profit? Well, profit is a way one wants to get a little ahead of others in devotional service also, in bhakti. And how I will be able to get better name, fame and prestige by performing this. Okay, so I will pick up some services which are in limelight. Why? Because I will get more fame than others. Now this is subtle game in devotional service. Puja, labha and pratishta. Pratishta is a tendency to stand, be, you know, outstanding. Like somebody exclusively says, well, the deities are coming, I want to get the deities. Only I will not allow anyone else to contribute. Whatever is the Lakshmi, I will contribute for the deities, so the deities will be mine. So that is pratishta, distinction. So these are all tendencies of subtle lust, which exists in a very, very fine way. It's very difficult to detect. Yeah, because they also come in the form of a cowherd boy. They may look like bhakti. They may look like a bhakta. But actually, they're very deep. So such things can be corrected only by Guru. Again. So it's Guru who actually rectifies this mistake. He sees the problem in the disciple. So when Guru sees the problem in the disciple, he is the one who will punish and correct the disciple. Pad! He punished him, right? Yes. No puja la pratishta. This is wrong. And then disciple, okay Gurudev, fine. He is humbled and he is corrected. So Guru's chastisement is the way to rectify this particular anartha of pralambasur, subtle lust. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So tomorrow is Balaram Jayanti. So we all can pray to Balaramji, because Krishna gave Bhagavad Gita. Bhagavad Gita is called the sword of knowledge. But we are all so powerless. We cannot even lift that sword. We don't have strength. So even to lift that sword of knowledge, you need strength. Correct? So that strength to lift the sword of knowledge, that spiritual strength is given by Balaram. So Balaram gives that spiritual strength to lift that sword of knowledge. And then one can use that sword of knowledge to cut away our unnecessary attachments. Asanga shastrena dridena chitva. So that is the... So you want spiritual power, spiritual strength? We should pray to Balaramji. Okay? Dauji Balaramji ki jai. Krishna Bhagavan ki jai. Jagat Guru Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Grantrashtrama Bhagavatam ki jai. Thank you all very much. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.